זה לא פשוט, זה לא סיפור פשוט, מאוד לא. אותם אנשים עובדים על זה.
These are the people that control the little toys that are in the foreground.
Ah,
As big as the dolly may look, one person is pushing it. Different kind of tracks than the ones we are used to. This is the same model as the big guy we've just seen on the table. It's about 2 feet long. It's pretty warm on this third. Temperature, I would say, is about 75 to 77 degrees. The guy's been inside the costume now for, I would say, 20 minutes with the mask full on and everything. I think they're ready to shoot. I'm trying to find the moment when the guy's gonna do his action so we can catch you on film. They're arguing about marks on the floor, whether it should be this point or that point. Very meticulous about everything. They change things, they take forever. Then they're getting ready. They've gone back to one. The guy here is ready with the little toys.
Yeah, let's go. Yo, hey!
You can see the bird going up and the little toys move to the side. I had to have a cut, of course. Focus cooler, take a measurement. People are standing along the line with shiny boards. They had a cut and then coming back. Back to one. I guess they had a good take. They're moving on to another shot. This is one of the transportation. They're wrapping all the mattresses. When we arrived, they just did a high fall from the roof. They had the camera on the bottom. These are the camera trucks, or van, I should say. The director is the guy with the black jacket and the white hat. And the one with the white jacket is the DP. The grips walk around with the shiny board. And we're moving into the forest right now. Over there. We're just at the entrance to some kind of a temple. The guys are having fun. This, by the way, is a craft service. Water and a bin for the cigarette butts. We are moving to the next location. I would say there are about 20 people here. He must be one of the actors. So here again is the whole company. two camera vans with the director. He's in Ariflex camera. I'll take care of it. I'll take a shot of it later. This is the entrance to an interesting palace they have here. And this is where we are going to for the next shot. Everybody's moved ahead there. It's an automatic focus, so it takes a while. This is where they moved to. It seems like they have a 5-ton or, well, more like a 2-ton. I'll take care of it. I'll take a shot of it later on.
Where?
Motorcycles, all kinds. All kind of motorcycles. Miniatures. This is the treadmill they use, one of those storage places where they have left overs from many, many shows.
Here's the drill from the Dragon Ranger over there. See that drill over there?
That's it.
You saw it?
Yeah. This is coming out. And here are some of the helmets. This is the helmet for live action. And you can see they have holes instead of the visor. Maybe from the inside we can see it too. So they can see through it. This is a Corvette transformed into a picture car. Look at the details. How's it take? So we go for the second take. This is what the camera is. These are the only two lights. We are in a place that everybody would recognize. Great. And that was a take. They're moving for next. This is a fight choreographer with a black jacket. New setup. They just told everybody to move their equipment from here.
Yeah.
Only two lights. One. What does it take? Choreographer there. He's instructing. These are the heroes of this new series. These guys. The ones who are in the frame except the one with the hat. I'm not cutting on purpose, so that we can see the real time. How long it takes him to get a new setup. Okay. That was a take. Ready or not, I wasn't ready. Trying to find a position that can include it all in the one frame. Take the measurements. Guy there with the hat, keeping the fist as where to look in the eye direction. Okay, stand by. Kumba means picture. The guy standing there. We're gonna clap the board. That was a cut. It was a take. And I think it was okay. And I'm moving to the next one. Was only a few seconds long. Rehearsals. See, you're rehearsing, the end of rehearsal. Shiny boards into place. Light is not working this time. Boomba. Picture's up. The cut. Oh, the cut. You just hear slowly. Moving in for a close-up, and I will move in too. As you can see, they spend no time moving around, and they don't bother to shoot everything in one direction first. They shoot the whole sequence in complete continuity, because it doesn't take them any time to move the camera around.
Goodbye.
and three horses.
あ、これ大事なのだけど。良くなるんだよ、今度は。それがこうやって応援だみたいな。やるわいな。うわーって言わないと。まだ。ね。じゃあ、本当にやってみるよ。ああ、あまり前出るなって言われたでしょ。はい。本番ですと。はい。お前たちから血祭りにあげてやるわいな。うわー。はい。もう一回。
I guess this guy, she becomes this guy. So. So he took her place. No real markings on the floor. She just finds her precise spot. And as you can see, I'm not cutting to show you real time for him. Bumba, victory is up. But everybody's laughing as she continued. They marking her spot exactly. I mean, the assistant cameraman just, without marking, just put his finger exactly, and the new monster's taking their place. It was a roll and a cut. There's a zipper in the back of this monster, and it just peels off. And it's a new setup. In the meantime, all he did was turn the camera around and these guys already ready. Our good guys. He's going setting up. Makeup is touching up. Okay. Since the last time I cut, when you saw the monster, until this, I would say it took about 45 seconds to 60 seconds for this new setup. They're all ready, they just completed the rehearsal. I had to talk to Haim for 2 seconds. And we are both totally impressed. And they're ready. This is a rehearsal. The advantage is that they shoot in complete continuity. They almost cut, edit in the camera the way they shoot it. And here is a person who always gives them a high line. The director is watching here. Bumba. They had a cut. Now the leave it extended for continuity. In the meantime, this cut was only for about 20 seconds. And I'm continuing with the real time. And you can see they haven't moved. They left their wrist gadget, whatever, pulled out. There is no problem of continuity to remember, because they shoot in continuity. The actors are practicing in the meantime. Cameras moved, and they're rehearsal. That was rehearsal already. Camera is adjusting. The script supervisor is blocking the view a bit. As you can see, this guy here is studying the script. I think he's a kind of fight choreographer, acting coach or something like that. This cut that I cut now was about 8 seconds. Picture. That was a cut. Director and DP. This is the monster we saw earlier on. Took place that took the girl's place when she transformed into him. As you can see, he's wearing it the whole time. He's just opening up to breathe a bit, but he's ready at all time. His hands inside and everything. Other people ready also. The rest of the cast is standing by. And this is again the amphitheater we just shot here. This is the very famous amphitheater that we saw in many shots. They all the time carry this trampoline and the mats everywhere they go. And the only track around I see is this one. In the meantime, they're getting ready to shoot over there. And I'm gonna get closer to. I would say this company move took about 3 minutes to be ready. Stand by for picture. Mumba.
The wire got disconnected.
The director telling him. Camera repositioning it a little bit. The guy here with the back to me is the second AC. And he also takes the light reading all the time. This is another prop that doesn't move. These are rehearsals. This guy was signaling for the guy with the shiny board to move closer. Picture. There's a cut. Picture. Seems like they're putting some kind of watch device on his wrist. It was a take. Finally, had a good one. This is the longest I've seen him. I guess they're looking for the new setup. Yes, I'm. I didn't tell him.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah. But go ahead.
Go ahead, sir.
This is a stand-in that stands there just for framing purposes. And our actor is here on the left in the white Pumba. That means picture is up. What was the take? Here comes the next one. The actor is getting ready. It's a new setup, as you can see. And I'm not cutting to show the real time. We have an overcast sky today, so lighting is relatively simple. But I have a feeling that they would live with this kind of procedure even in a sunny, bright day.
Zilla never laid on the floor for us.
Ask him.
That was a rehearsal. They're sleeting right now. And here's the stand-in again for framing. Mumba. Picture. Cut. One take. That's all he takes. If it's a good take, that's all he takes. And you can see they're moving again. Some reason they are changing directions all the time when the sky, although the sky is complete overcast, so I don't know that they can tell which direction is what, but they must know what they're doing. The camera crew here. Changing lenses again. As you can see, we're already in this direction, and they chose to turn around. Camera is on sticks on the other side. And I better move so I'm not in the frame. What was the take? They're running to get something, not clear what. They move the camera about 1 foot back. Next one is getting ready. Rehearsal. Camera is here. It's getting ready. Picture. There's a take. Helmet comes off. They opened the guy's back. As you can see, they're turning around once more. The choreographer is setting up the fight while the camera there. He's setting up to move the mattresses out of the way. Rehearsal.
It's over, over.
Yeah.
The shooting now.
Right.
One rehearsal, shoot.
They put the helmet on this guy, as you can see.
Yes, there is a good conclusion for the film that is necessary to continue Power Ranger. So it will always be one of the people on top of the entry.
Okay, stand by for picture. Picture. Two takes this time. I think they were trying to get the helmet off. Still a rehearsal. Supervisor blocking the frame a little bit. I think he's saying he's ready for picture. They slated it.
はい。頭。はい。はい。はい。オッケー。大丈夫かお前。はい。はい。
Okay, picture is up. What's the take?
We get a picture for you from here. Because he wants to stay. He wants to stay, him and me.
Somebody's moving. One person that attends them. Including the guy with the sword on the left. Picture is up.
Okay.
It was a cut. Are we moving on? The DP and the director Just don't. Get a test. I cut just for about 20 seconds. Kumba. Picture.
Okay.
It was a cut. One take. Camera is moving again. I guess they're discussing the exact action. The boobs is trapped under the armpits. They have this thing to make her chest flat, I think. Plus it's attached to the hood. Lunch break is about to be over. I think it's another 10 minutes. Everybody's starting to get ready. These are all stunt people. It's a team. During lunch break, they've been all rehearsing. Some kind of device with cables, so I'm not sure what it is. Jump to help each other. Oh, I know what they're doing. They're gonna put squibs. Placement on the chest. I'm waiting for it to turn around. I don't know if you can see, as soon as she turns around, this is a is the guy that's been doing it for 20 years. The one in the green. Know how to put it themselves. They run the cables so that they can themselves activate it. The girl is placing the squib there. Looks like they're starting to rush now. The rest of the crew is coming back. Seems like he's gonna have the device that explodes the squid over there. All in all, it's a team of like, I would say by 12 people who started working on all those squibs and putting the costumes together. And they're all one team of the stunts that during lunchtime. After finishing eating, they were doing some jumps on the trampoline, etc., having fun, but being ready on time. It's 1 o'clock and they already did one rehearsal. They came back for lunch, but 3 minutes ago. And they... No, maybe it was a take even, when I was not paying attention. Because I think the camera is moving already. In the time it took to move the camera from here to here, the rest of the crew ran and cleared everything. I put it all behind. All the costumes are designed the same way. So the zipper, velcro, zipper in the back, velcro. And all these guys already have the explosions already on them. It seems like now we're going to get into the actual fight sequences. Rehearsal.
やられてどうする。大丈夫か。いや、宮崎さん、ついてた。すいません。じゃあ、宮崎さん、次は。まっすぐ行ったら。大島と入ってたんです。ダメなんじゃない。いや、今からで大丈夫。はい、じゃあ、迷いで。
again, I'm not cutting. To give a good sense of the real time. Look how many people are helping out. Well, this girl is holding a prop. Picture is up. I'm just yelling to the spectators. Rehearsal. End of rehearsal. Stand by. And this is all real time. Special effects and everything. Because it's picture, no rehearsal. It was a take. Camera moves on. Incredible. Look at them all running. That was picture. No squibs. Mbam means picture. with the cuts. As you can see, they're moving on. Moving the mattress. Taking the heads off for a second. Camera is moving over there. In the meantime, the sun came out a bit. Still overcast, just a little bit. The helmets. Take the measurements. Picture. Was the cut. And they're moving on. Unbelievably fast. In the meantime, they're choosing the next setup, and again. So you don't think that I was telling you stories. I haven't cut yet to show you how long it takes. They just placed a ladder and a black duvetin in front. The monster is going to be standing in front of that. Equal distance from here to this guy. Setting lights on the sky there. Standing. They give him exact line of advancement. The marks on the floor. Give him a mark. Rehearsal.
そうだね。こんな坂本。はい、そこだな。坂本。はい、出た。出た。ああ。はい。はい、OK。はい。はい、それでいいよ。えっとね、坂本も、その足が見えないように車で隠れてるんで、そうそうそうそう。巻いといてそうやって。
The second assistant cameraman now is taking distance. Or light measurements, I would say.
Hey!
Choose up.
Hey! Hey!
Really cut. You can see because of the script supervisor. They're rolling.
Hey, okay.
That was it. Two people take the costume off this guy. These guys are standing by waiting for the monster. Over there. With the marking and everything. At the same time, the monster did something different there. Stand by for picture. Look at one of the actors, stunt person, runs in to check that everything's okay. Pictures. No, maybe it was just rehearsal. Picture. Rehearsal, sorry. Picture is up. The explosion device, they don't use any protection, it's their squibs. You can blow them out in your hands and it won't cause any damage. This is a special effects man. And you cannot take it out of the country, but they attach it to the body without any problems. Without any problem, they attach it to the body. Now, I don't know if it's recorded from the beginning, so I'm starting all over again. This is the squib that they're using. It doesn't require any protection on the body. What he's using is just a regular medicine capsule, and it puts gunpowder inside, and there's something that creates a spark inside. He makes it himself. There's a battery in the back, behind their back, and something, a switch in their hand, and they activate it themselves. They use no protection whatsoever on their body, and it's kept away about an inch, 3/4 of an inch on the body, that's all. And they just put another layer of cloth on top of it just to disguise it, but that's it. Using this chemical in a bottle to drop this stuff that makes smoke. Picture is I guess I missed a big explosion just ahead. A huge explosion. This is the cut immediately after that. And the explosion was just about 2 feet in front of him. And of course, no protection or nothing. Ta-da!
This is Shienka.
Shienka.
煙だ。普通には売ってません。ぜひお試しください、一度。You
have to translate for me, please. What is he saying?
Please try. This will make no smoke. It works well. So why don't you buy it?
It's a demonstration. That's titanium chloride. I guess it's been very funny because I asked him to make it like a commercial. Yeah, go ahead. The stick they're using, it doesn't contain any chemicals, it's just a sponge to take the titanium chloride out. In the meantime, there's a crane that is pulling up. I guess we're going to be in a picture site. This is the spot I was just standing at, and just for the record, they said that 4 days ago they shot 175 setups in one day. Today, because of the explosions and all that special effects, they're going to do only about 80. And soon enough, there will be a crane coming in, and they're going to do a guy flying. All this in one day. In the meantime, all these guys are hanging out in full uniform, the props on them. It seems like just now they decided that they're gonna undress them and put different uniform on them. No dressing rooms. No, nothing. It's all camping style. Like 5 minutes delay because they're reloading and they clean the camera and everything, which is the first time I've seen it the whole day. I guess it's the first magazine they're reloading. The rest of the crew are waiting here. This guy's kind of production manager, location manager, the guy who did a commercial for the stuff. In the meantime, the other actors are going to be next, are standing there, not going to be standing and waiting. How many feet of film do you shoot a day?
600.
A day?
A day.
Perfect. He doesn't understand what he's saying. We're just imitating. We told him how to say it. He's a great guy.
Nineteen years,
huh? What does he do? All the years the same thing?
All the same thing.
Different shows but the same job?
Yes, all related to action.
And the guy in yellow?
12 years.
12 years. And the one in the blue?
Another 12 years.
12 years that he's doing the same thing?
Yes.
And the guy in the red?
11 years.
Ask him if the explosions on their body hurts, if they feel it.
Doesn't hurt.
No.
He's scared, he says. The green one. It depends on the person, he says.
We're sitting up. A crane over there. Very efficient. While they're shooting one place, they're setting up the next one all the time. I just learned that most of these people are employed on a probably for life basis. There's no 100% guarantee, but that's the kind of work they do. And as you just heard from the people in costumes, the stunts, they've been doing it from 12 to 19 years and probably will do it until they can't do it anymore. System of two pulleys that are attached to a high point, using the crane just as a high point. They use very, very thin wires. that I don't know that we can barely see them. This is the stunt crew. I'm waiting to pull the wires. Stand by. Rehearsal. Same shots. The guy with the black hat is the first assistant director. They're helping the thing. I don't know, maybe paint the cable? I'm not sure. To make sure that. I think they're marking it with the China. With the China. One is wiping the cable off and the other guy. Can you believe this? Two China markers. To make it look blank. These guys on top of the hill, I would say, have been waiting for about 35 minutes now, on the spot, with full costumes, saying nothing. I think they're getting ready now. We can go for another rehearsal. Oh no, I think it's going to be possibly a take because they're putting the helmet on. With all this efficiency, it seems like they're also having fun. They don't run too much. Picture.
Cut.
Picture. So cuts. Everybody jumps. Everybody knows what they're doing. Those bits of the job. They're just extremely efficient. Camera is moving up there, and I'm going there too. And this is the craft service. Iced tea, not ice, cold tea, and some sweets. And except during the lunch break, I haven't seen anybody touch it. We can see they shoot more or less in continuity. They almost cut the movie in the camera. And I found out earlier that they shoot about 600 feet a day, and it's probably 95% usable, if not 99%. Starting position for the next take. The camera they're using, and just regular standard wooden sticks. Notice that the DP is using white gloves during the whole day. It's just cleared. I would say about 2 minutes. We're rolling.
Hey! Hey!
It's a cut. It's always okay. These guys, I guess, are released. They change, go to change. There's a rehearsal. So rehearsing as soon as the camera was in position. Seconds later, helmets are brought in. Those were the actors that were wrapped. Stand by, I suppose.
Humba.
Hey!
Humba.
This picture. Camera's moving again. The DP is going to put in the back to clear, but otherwise it will be in the shot all the time. This is like the stunt crew. They take care of their own uniform, their own props, their own safety, their own costume, everything. In the meantime, the camera was here a second ago. It's all gone. They took the rickshaw, they took everything. And I'm gonna go there myself. This is the stunt crew there. This guy's getting the shiny boards. Two shiny boards, look how light they are. And into the truck, because this time they're moving. And over there's the Jenny, and he's a little kid actor who's been hanging around all day. The stunt people carry all their equipment in these boxes. The uniform and everything. Somebody carrying the trampoline. They pack it, I'm talking about literally minutes from the moment the camera was on the top of the bleachers, I'm going to be ready to go. Gotta get out of their way. And they're going to the next spot. One of the actors. They're packing up everything in the question of minutes, literally minutes. And you can see nobody's really just rushing, they're just very extremely efficient. Everybody knows what they're doing. It's almost like they've rehearsed the same move 20 million times. Maybe they did. And this is the park, and you can see some kids gathering around, admiring what's going on. Oh, here we have. We're having some fun.
Okay.
Umba.
だから仕事が遊びだからそんなに疲れることはないんですよ。だから毎日がスケジュールびっちりでも現場が楽しいからそれで OK。わかりますか？
これこれ頑張るよ。
Now you translate.
No, you will. I did already.
Okay, what he just said is that they don't mind working even 7 days a week because they enjoy the job so much. They work sometimes 7 days a week. This guy is 19. This is the green Adam. He's 25. This is a new location. We just drove about, I would say, 3/4 mile from one location to the next in these two buses where they carried everybody in the crew. And as you can see over there, the two trucks. And this is generally the park. They're shooting all their episodes, all the exteriors. It used to be an American Air Force base. That's why there's such an ample, vast space, which is very, very expensive and rare in Tokyo. and it was donated back to the government of Japan. Well, donated back, I guess it always belonged to them. And they kept it as a big park, and they shoot all their exteriors in this park. There are many, many looks. It's quite big. Yesterday came to observe the miniature set. The rehearsal. The camera crew. The next shot is the little monster doing a little flip. And getting ready. A little smoke. Okay, just. Yeah. Actually, it was not smoke, it was just pressured air on a dusty floor. And you can see in front of the camera, this foreground is here. Pay attention how quickly they move to the next one. The robot is moving in. Camera move a tilt down along the body of the robot. Look for the slate. MOS, of course. This is the special effects man, if you're remembering from yesterday, who showed me the capsules in the meantime. We're getting ready for a test. Test stop, as they say. It was a test Are like 5 to 10 seconds at most. All is done simultaneously. Well, while they're prepping here the robot for the next shot, this guy will be in the next shot. It's this monster who makes a speech. One of the longest takes I've seen so far.
Hey!
I call him Oyes. Pictures up. This is one of the 80s. When he was in the club aboard. It was late, but then to call action in cut. From the BP says Umba, which is picture. He repeats it. This guy was born in air. This guy stands by the door, opens and closes the door every time there's a long enough cut to let the dust and the smoke come out. Now, we put the helmet. Some nice adjustments. While they're preparing the robot, it takes quite a while, although relatively fast. Remember, he has an explosive in his hands this time. Just a word to show how the lighting works. But I'll get to it in a minute because I think I'm getting ready to go. But generally, they make sure there are no shadows on the wall. There are the lights on the top, all along the top. They are behind the robot facing the wall. And then all the other lights around facing such an angle that no shadow is cast on the wall behind. And here we go, stand by.
はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。はい。
stoplights are behind the robot, facing the wall. There's never shadow. They like the psych behind. Okay, we got the picture here. That was a cut. It was a good take. And that was it. Very, very rarely do we see them take more than one take. I'm gonna go for one now. Here's one of the monsters, and you see all they do is they open up the bag, they take their costume head off a bit, just for, and it's pretty hot, I should say. Pretty, pretty hot in here. Here's the next one. This guy is a fight choreographer, and very elusive, very difficult to see him make a move. I guess they all know the action so well that occasionally he gets on the stage. Very occasionally does he demonstrate what to do. In most cases, I missed it. What's the take? In the meantime, it's taking off. Okay. Very good take. They're walking off with set two. They just called lunch. Look at this. Everybody is wrapping the stuff very quickly. They open the doors. keep everything out. And we can count the seconds. They are out of here. Over there is our friend Babu. He's naked now. Literally, it's less than 30 seconds and everybody's out. We're going to eat lunch. And so will I. Today it's sushi. This is made of rubber and this is, these parts are wetsuits, like a rubber suit, and they all have, this is kind of rubber portion, and the same for this part. And this, as you can see, it's pretty flexible. This is going to be one of the robots. And here is the rest of the equipment for the other robots. And as you can see, these are rubber suits with drawings on them. Well, this part is kind of rubbery too, foam, etc. Camera they're using. And this is the tripod, one of them. Baby legs. Wooden legs. Here's a cut. I just found out that the cameraman never deals with the lights. He just sets. The second cut. The cameraman doesn't deal with the lights. There's a group of electricians. Three takes as you must have seen a very, very, very rare situation. The guy here with the black hat is the second AC, but also takes the light measurements. And the one here in the front on the left is the second AD. Flaps. And the guy holding the lights over there is kind of the key gaffer with them. Climbed on the roof on the cuts walk. You're interested in the guy? Here's underneath. This is our guy Babu in the robot. There's another robot there standing by that we just saw him in red previous take. And over there, okay, if you're not careful, you're gonna roll without me being ready. So the stage is not too big. And there's a guy here on the left with the air tanks. Over there, by the way, we're seeing some of the city miniatures.
もうちょっとね膝を伸ばしてみて、ぎゅっと。そうそうそうそう。とても目立ちます。
That means pictures up. The guy on the left. I think this cut is about 5 seconds. That's all. Now again. Somebody helping the robot. It practically edits the film within the camera. He sits on. It's about a foot length, then 2/3 of a foot width. Let's go. Cut on the test. The guy who blows the air, if you can see his shovel, some kind of their equivalent fuller's earth, which they use from time to time with the round of dust. Building the robot is quite procedure, and the guy is very, very hot, but they're very efficient. They only keep in costume for the time needed. And as soon as it cuts, they take it off. The rehearsal, which they call the testo, they do with only the essential parts, definitely without the helmet. And only prior to shooting they put everything on. Look how many people are working on it. And they've done it for years. Gloves. Time they're putting a special thing on the hand, which they just finished screwing in. Here's the guy. Throwing this liquid. Picture. Those are cuts. Picture is up. They just use a little bit more color earth. The cut. And here we go immediately. In the meantime, next person up. Picture. And the cut. Few more guys run on his head, I mean, towards the person. Oh. Maybe a now this is all real time, you can see how little time it takes them to set every shot. And the interesting thing is that you don't hear any AD shouting or screaming or telling what to do or informing. Somehow they all know what's going on. I guess they do communicate somehow. next setup. Below the frame line, who is giving them instructions only verbally. Okay. Just stop. Okay, all the pieces come on. And I'm gonna save film. In the meantime, this other robot is sitting and waiting for his turn, full costume. Probably pretty hot. Those people that are wearing masks is because of the dust. Up. This time they use the trampoline, just stand on it.
Come on.
What's it about? We're discussing the next shot.
Take.